In this video, I'll show you how to light up an interior scene from dark black to photorealistic lighting in a simple and easy way in 3ds Max. If you wanna see how this scene was made from modeling through materials and lighting to rendering, I'll leave a link to a video in the description box. Also, only a small percentage of people that watch my videos are actually subscribed. So if you end up enjoying watching my videos, consider subscribing, you can always change your mind. Alright, this is the scene that I'm gonna work on today, and I'm gonna be using 5 types of lighting. Starting with light number 1, dome light. Go to Vray light, then choose dome type light. Put it in the viewport like so. Let's go to the camera and see what happened. But first, I want to turn the override material on from the global switches. Turn it on and put a Vray material. Exclude the curtains. When you exclude something from the override material, it won't be affected by the override. Alright, let's hit render. There is a slight light comes from the window, but it's very dark. I can go to the dome light parameter and increase the light intensity from the light multiplier. Or simply go to the camera parameters and increase the light intensity either from the shutter speed and the f-number or from the exposure. The result is fairly good, but it didn't seem natural. So I'm gonna add an HDR IMAP to the dome light. Let's save this shot just like this. Select the HDR I, go to its parameters, click on no map like so. Then on Vray bitmap, finally choose the HDR image. Copy the HDR I map to a slot in the material editor in order to have access to its settings. And copy it to the environment map as well. Hit render to see what we have achieved so far. Yep, there is a difference. The shot is still a bit dark, it needs more light. Go to the HDR IMAP in the material editor. Increase the overall material like this. Now it's better. Moving on to light number 2, sphere light. I have this table light and this floor light, and I want to light them up. Select both of them and isolate them. Go to top view, then go to lights, Vray lights, type sphere. Put the sphere in the middle of the light. Make an instance copy and drag it to the other light. Then place them exactly where they should be. Determine their light multiplier and color. Alright, let's see what happened. Pretty cool, but it needs more intensity. Light number 3, the mesh light. Select this roof and hide it. As you can see, there is a space around here because I want to make hidden light in this place. Make line. Move its edges inside a little bit. From rendering, click on enable on render and on viewport checkboxes and determine its thickness. Convert it to editable poly. Go to Vray light. Choose mesh light. Put it anywhere inside the viewport. Go to its parameters. Click on mesh light, then on pick mesh. Select the line that we have made just like this. Now it's no longer a line, it's light source. Let's change its light multiplier and color. Great result. Next step is to light up this space with different color. I'll do the same thing I did to the hair and light. One thing I should do different is to hide the light source. Nice result. Now it is the time for light number 4 and 5. I'll use them together. First I'll make a spotlight in this place, model it. Then material it. And exclude it from the override material. Beautiful, isn't it? But it needs to be stronger. Second, I'll use Vray IES light like so. Randomize the IES light targets to get better results. And increase the HDRI light intensity again. That is the final result. Hope you liked it. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. See you next time.